I made a very basic video back in 2020 and I have realized that there are many flaws. First, it's only up to 3 digits and the algorithm cannot be scaled to 5, 7 or 9 digits. Second, it gives wrong output in few cases like 119, 218, etc. So today, we are with the advanced program for converting numbers to words, which is completely scalable and can handle exceptional cases and sure has a simple logic.
Hi, I'm charAt and welcome to the Education Valley. Today we have another amazing video on the Java program. So let's do it.
Theory. So we try to break down the question. Let's start with a few examples. 12118, which should give the output 12,118. 1229, 1229. 11111, 11111. From taking multiple examples, we see 4 problems to be solved. Tens place, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, etc. Unit place, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. 100, 1000, lakh, crore, etc. And last, 11, 12, 13, etc. So the new approach could be to place the respective words for each digit in a string using a loop that runs for the number of the digits in the number. Let's do that by starting the code while explaining the concepts. First, as always, we write the layout, then scanner, then start the actual program. Step 1, take the number. Step 2, we need to know the number of times we need to run the loop. For that, we either take a loop which goes through the number and count the number of digits. Or convert the number to a string and use .length function to get the number of digits. Here, we will go with the second one as it has benefits ahead in the program. Third, we declare variables. We declare the variables we may need in the program. This goes on as we go through the program, so leave some space for it. For now, we just declare variables int I is equals to 0 for the loop and string z is equals to null for adding the respective words at their positions. Step 4. Now we are all set. We can start the loop. In this case, the easiest way will be to run a backward loop. So we start our conversion from number to words backwards, starting from unit place and taking it to the highest place. This approach will help us count the digits that have been converted and would give a general order as unit place digit will be converted first to their respective words. Step 5. Now we are inside the loop. First, we extract the digit from the number. For this, the best method would be using charAt I, which then can be converted back to integer using Integer.valueOf, String.valueOf. Here, String.valueOf is also needed as Integer.valueOf is used to convert number from string to int and not char to int, and string.valueOf will convert character to string for it. After that, we can declare and assign basic arrays from which our loop extracts the words and place them in the place of digits. And here, it will be wise to make the position of words to correspond directly to the respective digits. Now let's start with the easiest and broadest category and move up. First, for tens place, 10, 20, 30, etc. This being the broadest category can be placed in the else block. and the word from the array for the digit can be added to our null variable. Here it is important to add values in front of the null variable as loop is backwards. Second, for unit place 1, 2, 3, etc. The same can be done only while using an else if block. For the condition, we will have to look at an example. Example 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 91,23,456. By observing, we see that the first occurrence in every set has a unit place word. To accomplish this, we use another variable to count digits crossed, and which we will have to reset after every 100,000 lakh, etc. Step 3 for 100,000 lakh crore, etc. For this, we can declare a number and use it to count the digits converted, and when it hits 2, the loop will insert 100, on 3 1,000, on 5 a lakh, on 7 a crore, and so on, then reset the previous counter. Part 4 for 11, 12 and teenage numbers. For solving this, the last part, the main part of the question. Challenges here are controlling when to print and identifying when such a number like 13, 14, 15 occurs. For identifying, we can keep extracting the digit along with its previous digit. For extracting, we can use substring. And then use integer.valueOf for converting extracted string to integer. But only till before the first digit of the 0th place to avoid out of bound exception. Plus, there is a catch here. At last position, we may need to change the last digit's number to some non 13, 14, 15 number. Otherwise, at last, it will keep adding from the wrong array. We can then add the corresponding word from array to our string variable. But in number like 1212212, 1 crore 21 lakh 21,212, in such a number, when our loop points to second, third last, or fifth last, or seventh last, etc., it can be here less than 20, that is, in the space of numbers like 13, 14, 15, but we will not need it here. So by applying NNN modulus 2 not equal to 0, we will eliminate the odd occurrences, that is, third, fifth, seventh places. But it seems we would need the 0th position, which is also an odd occurrence. So we would need to make two else if blocks, one for 0th and other for third, fifth, seventh, etc. And a keen observer will notice that the numbers such as 13, 14, 15 occupy two digits places and print only one word, as a result disrupting the natural flow of the loop. So inside these loops, we'll need to make more changes to show the loop that two digits have crossed and to the variable that are keeping count. After all these, we just add an statement for 0. And the program is ready to be battle tested. Step 6. At last, we display the string variable along with an appropriate message. If you have understood the program or if you are facing any problem, feel free to leave a comment. You can also check the program from link in the description below. And if you have learned something, leave a like and subscription for us to enjoy. And sharing these videos will help a student like you. Thank you.